This video, we're going to be looking at the AWS Universal Torque Screwdriver calibration machine. This is for ISO 6789 2017 and 2003. It's available in automatic or semi-automatic operation, calibrating torque screwdrivers and torque watches up to 30 newton meters. I'm going to start this video off by showing you some of the features of the Universal Torque Screwdriver calibration machine. The case contains a bright full-color LCD graphic display with the screwdriver type and transducer selection switches, the transducer selection switch acting a bit like a switch box. The stepper motor and toothed belt drive system that we have in the machine removes the need for operators to smoothly and consistently apply torque to screwdrivers as required by the standard. The machine runs through a learning operation when a screwdriver is first installed, which accurately plots the profile of the cam or brake action. This eliminates the variation found between different cams, ensuring that the machine meets the requirements of the standard for the time to increase the torque from 80% of the target value to the target value. The screwdriver to be tested is installed in the drive pulley using a custom handle drive adapter. We have a selection of these available, which are designed to meet common manufacturer screwdriver handle shapes and sizes. The transducers are mounted in a cradle, which can be raised and lowered to accommodate screwdrivers of different lengths. The screwdriver itself is mounted within 2 degrees of the vertical, as required by the ISO 6789 2017 standard. The handheld controller has switches for clockwise and counterclockwise, ascend and descend, along with push buttons for start and stop and a joystick for jog control. A consecutive number of operations can be selected, either 1, 3, 5 or 10 operations as required by the standard. And multiple safety features ensure that the machine, transducers and torque screwdrivers are not overloaded in operation or overdriven due to a screwdriver fault. Operation of the machine itself is very quiet, as you can see on our dB meter readout here, the only really discernible noise being the click of the screwdriver itself. As with our Universal Torque Wrench calibration machine, this can be used in collaboration with the AWS Kepler 4 software, which takes value straight from the display, speeding up completion of the calibration or certification process to ISO 6789 2017. Now we're going to look at some example operations, starting with the general installation and setup of the machine. Select the required transducer using the selection switch. Up to 3 transducers can be powered by the machine at once, maintaining temperature stability for instant use when required. You insert the transducer into the cradle using a precision torque adapter if required, in this case using a 1/4 inch to be used with our 10 newton meter transducer. The blocks on either side support the transducer during use. Based on your screwdriver type, either cam, dial or click type, change the screwdriver selection switch on the front panel of the machine to match the type of screwdriver you are going to be calibrating. Using the soft buttons on the front of the display, follow the on-screen setup. First peak auto cancel is required for cam or click type screwdrivers, but not for dial types. Select the units of measure which you're going to be using for your screwdriver, and then set the target torque. This is the torque value that the screwdriver is set to. Set the upper limit. This will stop the machine should this value be reached during operation, and this is by default set to 110% of the transducer's full scale value. Select the mode. First peak should be used for cam and click type screwdrivers, and peak for dial types. The display setup is now complete and will display ready to learn. Fit the screwdriver handle drive adapter into the top pulley of the machine, and then install the screwdriver into the machine using a square or hex adapter if required to connect the transducer to the screwdriver. Precision torque adapters are available if required. The cradle itself is raised and lowered by releasing the clamp screw on the side. Use the jog function on the joystick to align the screwdriver drive with the transducer input drive. Alternatively, if you prefer, the screwdriver can be rotated by hand by switching off the motor temporarily. You can then, by hand, rotate the screwdriver so that the square drive aligns with the transducer. Remember to switch back to the correct screwdriver type after rotating by hand. Then we set up the handheld controller, selecting clockwise or counterclockwise, ensuring ascend is selected, and it doesn't matter which position the number of operations rotary switch is in for the learning cycle. So we're going to start off with an example for cam type screwdrivers. So we've got one set up in the machine here. Press and hold the yellow button for half a second and release to run the machine. The machine will run automatically to learn the torque curve of each cam of the screwdriver. So in this example, where we've got a screwdriver with six cams, it will run around the six peaks. It plots the torque curve for each cam of the screwdriver. This ensures the torque application timings dictated by the standard are met for future operations of each cam. The standard states that the time to go from 80% to 100% of the target torque must be between half a second and 1 second. This means the machine will either speed up or slow down for that last 20% to ensure that it meets the requirements of the standard. Any peaks captured by the display are not transmitted on RS232 during this learning phase. That ensures that they aren't going to appear in your software, such as Kepler 4. If at any point you did have to stop the learning process, the machine would know that the learning process hadn't been completed and you'd just have to run the learning process again. This learning process would also have to be run again if you change the torque value of a setting type torque screwdriver, but it is a very quick operation and it doesn't require any input from the operator. The machine will stop when all cam positions have been learnt and will display ready to operate. You can then select the number of operations using the dial on the handheld controller and press and hold the yellow button for half a second and release to run the machine again. The machine will run and automatically complete the selected number of operations, so 5 operations in this instance. And these readings this time are transmitted on RS232 to the Kepler 4 software. The machine will stop automatically when it has completed the selected number of operations and will display ready to operate again, awaiting further input from the operator. Now we're going to have a look at dial type screwdrivers and the operation of these. This is a more manual process because the operator does have to stop the machine when the dial screwdriver reaches its target torque. So for dial types, it doesn't matter again what position the number of operations rotary switch is in. You press and hold the yellow button for half a second and release to run the machine. The machine will run, slowing automatically at 80% of the target torque, which aids manual stopping. Then when you reach the target torque, it's a case of pressing the red button to stop the machine. Switch to descend on the handheld controller and press and hold the yellow button for half a second again and release to run the machine. The machine will stop when it has returned to zero torque. Press reset on the display to clear the peak, and this will also transmit that captured peak on RS232 to the Kepler 4 software. To operate again, select ascend on the handheld controller and press and hold the yellow button for half a second and release to run the machine. This time you'll notice that the initial speed from 0 to 80% is much quicker. Once the screwdriver has completed one operation, the machine adjusts the initial speed so that the time taken to reach 80% is around 5 seconds. It still slows down at 80% so you can stop the machine at the target torque. If you need to slow the machine down sooner than that 80% level, then you can do so by pressing the yellow button at any time. This will slow the machine down to that approach speed, and that ensures that you can stop the machine at the target torque correctly. This is especially important if your screwdriver is overreading. Then, as before, it's just a case of pressing the stop button, switching to descend, and then running the machine, and it'll return back to zero again. Another feature of the machine that we can use is the jog function. So you can choose to manually stop with the red button when the target torque is indicated or roughly indicated, and then jog up to the target torque using the jog joystick on the handheld controller. This gives you more accuracy if you want to creep up and make sure you're exactly meeting the target torque value as indicated on the torque screwdriver. You can see in this example here, we can press the stop button and then just use the jog joystick to creep to the target torque. Then it's just a case of switching to descend again, pressing the yellow button for half a second, and the machine will descend back down to zero. Press reset on the display, as before, to clear the peak and transmit it on RS232. Now we're going to look at the operation of click type screwdrivers, which are a more unusual screwdriver type. But this is a very similar operation to cam types, starting off with a learning run, so pressing and holding the yellow button for half a second and releasing to run the machine. The machine will run automatically to learn the brake action of the screwdriver. This ensures that the torque application timings dictated by the standard are met for future operations. This first peak is not transmitted on RS232 during the learning phase. The machine will stop once it's returned to zero and will display ready to operate. You can then select the number of operations using the dial on the handheld controller and press and hold the yellow button for half a second and release to run the machine. The machine will run and automatically complete the selected number of operations, and each time the captured first peaks are transmitted on RS232 to the Kepler 4 software. Once again, the machine will stop once it's completed the selected number of operations, and it will display ready to operate, awaiting the operator's next instructions. So that's it. That's a brief overview of our torque screwdriver calibration machine. Again, if you've got any questions, please do not hesitate to let us know. You can contact us by going to our website, awstorque.co.uk, and clicking on Contact Us.